Hi, my name is Dr. Oren Litwin, and I head up the Islamism in Politics project for the Middle East Forum. What we do is we track the involvement of Islamists in the American political process. Now, what I mean by Islamists is not Muslims, because we have nothing against the Muslim religion, Islam. What we are against is a political ideology called Islamism, which actually has its roots in 20th century totalitarianism. Islamists want to use a religion as a justifying principle in order so that they can take political power. That is what Islamism is, as opposed to a religion. So we are against Islamism, and we're trying to track their activity with regard to American politicians, American campaign finance, and American lobbying. I've been monitoring Islamist campaign donations for some time, and there's been a very interesting trend over the last several years. The earlier generation of Islamists in the 1990s, early 2000s, the first generation of actual Muslim Brotherhood members who came over from overseas, they tended to donate money and to have political contacts with members of both parties. They're trying to spread their influence, gain friends wherever they can, and they're not trying to be partisan about it. This is not the case for the newer generation of Islamist activists who have grown up in America, who are experienced in American politics, and who largely have a partisan affiliation with one political party based on where they think their long-term alliance is. That political party is the Democratic Party. It's not because Islamists actually agree with progressive priorities such as LGBT inclusion or abortion. In fact, their religious commitments are very much against those things. However, they have recognized that the progressive movement offers a route to power for the Islamists. Islamist activists like Linda Sarsour, Rashida Tlaib, Ilhan Omar recognize that if they approach American politics and they present themselves to progressives under the banner of intersectionality, meaning that if you support minority rights, you must support Muslims, as they say, even though they don't speak for other Muslims beyond the Islamist group, and therefore we will support you, these activists have become vocal proponents of the progressive agenda, including things like LGBT inclusion, including abortion, including environmentalism, not because they necessarily agree with these things, but because they realize that that is the way to ingratiate themselves into the progressive coalition under the framework of intersectionality. However, progressives have been far too eager to accept their support. Tactically speaking, they wanted to use the Muslim community as a cudgel against President Trump. What they don't realize is that in private, Islamist activists are very willing to say that they have fundamental disagreements with progressives, and that when they have enough power, they will readily turn on them and implement their own priorities as far as LGBT, as far as abortion, and even as far as fundamentally restructuring our economic system so that it becomes more in consonance with traditional Islamic teachings about usury and charging interest. Many of those things would horrify progressives if the progressives only listened to what Islamists are willing to say to each other behind closed doors, and even not behind closed doors. For example, Ibrahim Samira, who was the Get Out the Vote director for Rashida Tlaib during her successful campaign, he said in a recent conference that the progressive alliance with Islamism was comparable to Muhammad's alliance with his enemies in his early career in the Arabian Peninsula, and as Muhammad became stronger, he was more and more willing to fight directly those who had previously been his allies. And he implied that Islamists are doing the same thing. And this is necessary because Islamists are facing a lot of internal pushback within their communities from religiously doctrinaire Islamists who think that allying with progressives on issues of LGBT and of abortion and other social issues that are against their beliefs is unjustifiable even for political expediency. One of the other new trends in Islamist involvement in American politics is that Islamists are running their own candidates for office now, whereas previously they would simply build relationships with more mainstream American politicians and support them as they ran for office. An example of this new breed of Islamist politician is Representative Ilhan Omar from Minnesota. Now, she's an interesting case because, unlike most politicians who are good at presenting themselves as moderate, Representative Omar seems totally uninterested. She has been willing to openly allude to anti-Semitic stereotypes such as Jews hypnotizing the world or Jews controlling American politics with money that most politicians would shy away from. In fact, it's gotten bad enough that even the Democratic leadership has openly rebuked Ms. Omar for making these statements that touch on anti-Semitic tropes. Now, Representative Omar and her supporters, like Linda Sarsour and like CARE, the Council on American Islamic Relations, will tell you that she is only being attacked for opposing Israel and its policies. And it is true that Representative Omar and Representative Rashida Tlaib are far more outspoken against Israel than any other politician that we've seen in recent memory. However, that is not why they are being attacked. It is possible to oppose Israeli policies without opposing the state of Israel's very existence, as they do, and without veering into anti-Semitism, as they do. It's very easy, if you are somebody who supports progressivism and progressive politics, to assume that any Muslim leader in the progressive coalition should be somebody you should support as well. And to be sure, most Muslims are fine American citizens and are committed to our way of life, even if they are religious. Again, it's not the religion of Islam that we oppose, it is Islamism, the ideology that mandates political supremacy. How can you tell if a given Muslim politician is simply a religious Muslim or is actually an Islamist? One way to tell would be if these politicians have open relationships with Islamist organizations such as the Council on American Islamic Relations or other organizations that are openly or covertly linked to the Muslim Brotherhood or Jamaat Islami or other transnational Islamist organizations that are more openly geared towards seizing power. Another way to tell would be to scrutinize their record. Have these politicians ever in the past expressed support, even qualified support, for terrorism? Have they supported using government power to censor criticism of Muhammad or other Islamic religious figures? Has their criticism of Israel crossed the line from simple opposition to the policies of an American ally to open demonization and dehumanization? Do these politicians say different things about LGBT inclusion or other social priorities of the progressives depending on who their audience is? When they're among Islamist audiences, are they more willing to hedge their support for such social issues and justify it in terms of political expediency rather than principle? If any of these warning signs are evident, then you should be careful to make sure that the politician you are thinking of supporting actually has the interests of the progressives or of America in general in mind. I'm Oren Litwin for the Middle East Forum. If you want more information about the work we do, you can visit meforum.org. Thank you very much.